Call the city council meeting to order. Roll call, please.
Alderman Caddella?
Here.
Alderman E. Wesley?
Here.
Alderman Coles?
Here.
Alderman Lewitton?
Here.
Alderman Police?
Here.
Alderman Shockey?
Here.
Alderman R. Wesley?
Here.
Alderman Winger?
Here.
Mayor Johnson?
Present. Quorum being present, we stand and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
May I motion approve the minutes of July 16th, 2009?
I'll make a motion.
Is there a second?
Second.
On the question? All in favor?
One question. Number five on the first page, it says the motion was made by Winger and seconded by Alderman, but nobody else.
Does anybody recall who made a motion to approve, second the approval of the bills? All right, we'll make that adjustment.
Okay.
Anything further?
Nothing further.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, motion carries. One abstention, Alderman Eugene Wesley. Bills, Alderman Winger?
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I make a motion to approve a list of bills dated August 6, 2009 for $659,834.16.
Is there a second?
I'll second it.
On the question? Roll call.
Alderman Lewitton?
Yes.
Alderman Police?
Yes.
Alderman E. Wesley?
Yes.
Alderman Caddella?
Yes.
Alderman Winger?
Yes.
Alderman Coles?
Yes.
Alderman R. Wesley?
Yes.
Alderman Shockey?
Yes.
That passes. Do any citizens wish to address the city council this evening? If so, if you go to the podium and give us your name and address, please. Mr. Wassinger?
Good evening, Mr. Mayor and council members. My name is John Wassinger. I come from the land from the east. At 255 South Church Road in the wonderful hamlet of Bensonville. I'm here this evening to speak to this board on behalf of Mr. He Park and Marguerite Ciucci, who are tenants in common and fee simple title holders of two parcels on Wooddale Road. I don't have any displays or anything, so if we can imagine Elizabeth Drive and Wooddale Road, they are on these. There's two lots which are on the east side of Wooddale Road, on either side of Elizabeth Court, both north and south. When the development went in, these were to be retained from development as retention areas for watershed in that, for that property's development. It has been a matter of discontent as far as the city's concerned because of the management and maintenance of those properties. However, there is great hardship with the title holders to do anything that would probably be needed in order to maximize the efficiency of the lot to the south, which would be regrading, and the maintenance on those. Ms. Ciucci is under great financial hardship and ill health. Mr. Park, who had himself maintained those for years by cutting the grass down when need be, also is advanced in years and finds himself not being able to do that. And it had come about that their request was to see if the municipality had any need for those parcels themselves. When that development was put in place, at that time, the overture was made that there was going to be increased water flow for the sewer system, improvements being made down Wooddale Road at some time in the future. That development never happened because it was said that at that time, those lots would probably, at least one of them, would be buildable at that time. Ms. Ciucci, who is a dear friend of mine,
lost her husband. She widowed during that project. It was actually her husband's project. So most of this responsibility was, you know, basically, unfortunately, put on her shoulders. And she just finds herself in a position really not to maintain it, I think, in a way that pleases the city. Some things were bandied about as far as usefulness, as maybe a site for a sign, welcoming people as they enter the gateway from Wooddale Road going north into the municipality, welcoming them to the land of zero bonding debt and benevolence. Other uses for that property, actually it had been brought to the Bensville Park District as possibly wanting to have that property, of which they would do a restoration with long-rooted native systems so that it wouldn't need to be mowed all the time, that it could just grow as an ephemeral wetland, bloom, blossom, and regenerate itself from year to year. We've spoken with staff at different times about the potential of fee simple title just being transferred over to the municipality. We've never really come to any clear decisions on this, and again, I just appeal to this panel to possibly find some way to help these people out of the dire straits that they're in with concern to this property. I thank you for your time. Does anybody have any questions for me?
Any comments or questions? We'll be taking this up at a future date. I do not have any written communiques under Mayor's report. A couple Saturdays ago, the Wooddale swim team hosted the regional swim meet. Holland Police, were you involved in that?
No.
Okay. Just checking. Are your kids? I wasn't sure. This is the meet that we helped contribute. We gave $500 as a sponsor, as a regional event, and I'm proud to announce that the swim team, Wooddale swim team, came in second place in the meet, so congratulations to them. Also want to remind all the residents of Wooddale Prairie Fest coming up August 14th, 15th, and 16th. This is going to be the biggest party that Wooddale has ever thrown in the history of the city of Wooddale. For those of you that know John Forrest, who works as head of the Community Development Department, his band, Heartache Tonight, will be playing Friday night at 6 p.m., followed by the band Infinity at 8:30. On Saturday, we have the Fairlanes at 3 p.m., Ides of March at 5:30, and the Buckinghams will be the draw at 8 p.m. on Saturday, followed by fireworks immediately thereafter. And on Sunday at 1 p.m., we will have the band Exide, and at 3:30, the band Seventh Heaven. In addition, there will be a carnival this year, and there are approximately 11 food vendors who have signed up for the event. For those of you that might be interested in parking, parking will be available behind City Hall, behind Suburban Bank, and at the old 7-Eleven site. There will be preference for senior parking and handicap parking, as well as the vacant lot will be available immediately to the east of that facility. Also, the Wooddale train station parking lot will be available for overflow parking. Does that about cover it? Cash boss and site boss and whoever else wants to be a boss. And speaking of bosses, we will have a sign-up sheet tonight for the alderman to help supervise the beer tent. So if you would be willing to take a two-hour shift Friday, Saturday, Sunday, that would be appreciated as well. And Alderman Wesley.
Did anyone get back to you about a dunk tank?
I was advised that they could not find one to book at this late date. However, if we can find one, I'm sure that there will be multiple people standing in line ready to willing to dunk you and some of the other aldermen who might want to volunteer to be in the tank. I could see where this would be a big money raiser for the city of Wooddale. Perhaps we can accommodate that, site boss.
Mr. Mayor, I'm out of space.
So perhaps we can work on that for next year. Anything further? That concludes my report. Mr. Manager?
Three items, Mr. Mayor. Just a couple updates with respect to some capital projects that are going on. The street resurfacing program is underway. The curb work is all done at this stage of the game. If you go down selected streets in the city, you'll see that the contractor has replaced some of the curbs that were deteriorated. Now that that's done, we're going to commence with the actual resurfacing itself. If you've been by Commercial Street, you'll notice that the two buildings that we have acquired are down, and rocks are being converted into gravel, and gravel is being converted into dust. And if everything works well, we'll have that cleaned up and ready to go for the Prairie Fest next week. Also, the city attorney has filed a petition for reimbursement of our legal fees with respect to acquisition of those properties. I don't know exactly where that is, but as of Monday, he told me that the filings had been done, and that's in process. And third, if you haven't heard already, our deputy city clerk is the proud mother of a baby girl. Shirley, was it Brianna?
Brianna
arrived on Tuesday morning about 9:30, so she's the newest member of the Wooddale family. And that concludes the report. Oh, I sent you a memo to that effect. We've chosen to take the acting word off of John Forrest's title of acting community development director. That will be effective, was effective on August the 1st. John has filled in ably since March of this past year as acting community development director, and he and I talked, and we've decided to make that position permanent. So when you see John, you can give him your congratulations. That's it, Mr. Mayor.
Any comments, questions? If not, that brings us to the consent agenda. Is there any objections to any items on the consent agenda? Alderman Shockey?
Number nine.
Number nine will be removed. Hearing none others, may I have a motion to approve the agenda being items 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10, and 11.
I'll make the motion.
Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. Now may I have a motion to approve the items on the amended consent agenda being approval for the installation of hosted VoIP phone system, resolution to adopt the annual 1,000-hour standard for IMRF participation, resolution relating to participation by elected officials in IMRF, resolution to include compensation paid under an Internal Revenue Code Section 125 plan, resolution of the City of Wooddale authorizing the adoption of the City of Wooddale Purchasing Manual, resolution authorizing the amendment to the license agreement between Elizabeth Park Condominium Association and City of Wooddale, resolution authorizing the execution of a license agreement between Bristol Park Condominium Association and the City of Wooddale, ordinance amending Chapter 15, Article 20, Section 15.2006 of the Code and Ordinance of the City of Wooddale, approval of contract award to Stoneham Street Water Main to R.A. Mancini in amount not to exceed $264,912, and approval of contract award for 2009 alley improvements to A-Lamp Concrete Contractors in amount not to exceed $459,675. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Roll call.
Alderman Lewitton?
Yes.
Alderman Police?
Yes.
Alderman E. Wesley?
Yes.
Alderman Cadella?
Yes.
Alderman Winger?
Yes.
Alderman Coles?
Yes.
Alderman R. Wesley?
Yes.
Alderman Shockey?
Yes.
Who made the motion to approve?
I did.
Alderman Wesley. Item nine will be taking up under other business. That brings us to committee chairman reports, planning, zoning, and building. Alderman Cadella?
No report.
Public health, safety, and judiciary. Alderman Shockey?
No report.
Public works. Alderman Wesley.
Mr. Mayor, I have a report about the School Street refiguration. I noticed that there was a tie at one and one motion failed. I guess I would obtain the motion to go with the second recommendation to move the parking west away from the residents' property. The only thing that I would like to add in that motion is that we look at removing it at blacktop at the end of that, because we have no guarantee that that blacktop will be moved at the end of that street. That will be my motion.
When you say recommend or look at, you mean you're directing that the blacktop be removed, correct?
I mean, I'd like to add that into this.
Yes.
Okay. Is there a second?
Second.
On the question? Alderman Winger?
So we're saying that we're going to extend according to the diagram given on July 20th, and that there will be blacktop extending?
Mr. Douthwaite?
I believe the motion is to go with alternative number two that Mr. Graff gave you 2 weeks ago, which is extend the street 73 feet to the west and relocate the parking lot. And I spoke to Mr. Graff yesterday about the existing blacktop past that cul-de-sac, and as part of the contract, we will have the contractor remove that parking or that blacktop, put in topsoil and sod so it'll look natural.
Okay, thank you. And then follow up, what is going to be the net to exceed amount on the change request?
It's a unit cost price, and Mr. Graff has estimated it at $15,000.
So will that be our dollar amount that we put on this?
I would give us a little flexibility if it comes in a little higher, that we just have the flexibility to go ahead and do it. But his best estimate at this stage of the game, until he actually gets the drawings complete and to the contractor, is an approximation of about $15,000. It shouldn't be plus or minus more than $1,000 one way or the other.
Okay, so in the motion, I'd ask that we add in $16,000 to exceed.
That ought to do it.
Alderman Wesley, do you agree?
I agree, Mayor.
Seconder agree?
Second agree.
Alderman Cadella.
Mr. Manager, you said that the blacktop removal and whatever it is, sodding or seating, is in the contract. That's in the original contract and does not need additional dollars.
No, that's in the contract. We had planned to do that all the time.
Should that even be in this motion?
Doesn't matter to me.
Anything? Fine.
Well, yes, Mayor.
Alderman Wesley.
Yes, I will ask that be in the motion because I got the feeling, sitting through these meetings before, that the Forest Preserve was going to remove that property, blacktop, and we weren't going to do anything. I just want to make it perfectly clear that we are going to remove that blacktop. I don't think your engineer department, which he isn't here tonight again, which I'm surprised, that it was not originally in the contract. Now, my question, again, that's why I wanted an emotion, because at first, I'm getting two side stories here now. I'm being told, yes, it was, and now it is. So, you know, that's why I wanted the motion that it gets removed.
Well, in defense of Mr. Graff, he had a prior commitment that came up before the council decided to hold this special meeting. We had decided earlier in June that we weren't going to meet tonight, and as a result, he had some plans that he couldn't change. So I agreed that I'd backstop him with respect to this discussion tonight. So I don't want to pin this on Mr. Graff that he's shirking his duties, if you will. And again, earlier this week, based upon a question I got from one of the aldermen a week or two ago, I asked him, is it our plan to remove that asphalt past the cul-de-sac? And he said, yes, it's an inconsequential cost to the overall cost of the project, and the plan is to take it out, put in topsoil, and sod it so it'll look natural.
Alderman, please.
Okay, I'm just looking at the plan here, and basically, I know we all received the call from the residents saying that the new parking was interfering with this driveway, and I've been out there a couple times. I'm looking at the drawing. Looks like it's 50 or 100 feet away from his driveway. I mean, we're going to make it. We discussed this a couple of times. We picked what we're going to do. Now, one phone call, we're going to spend an extra $15,000 because one resident complained. So if the other $13,000 start complaining about something, we should spend $15,000 for each of them. And so we'll spend a total of $195 million altogether. I would be happy to move it if I saw it was interfering with the driveway, but I don't see it. So that's why I've been voting no. And why spend an extra $15,000?
Alderman Shockey.
On the plan, it shows if we extend the street, we're also extending the parking. Is that correct?
We're not extending the parking. We're just moving the parking to the west. If you take a look at the sketch that you have in front of you, you essentially see three boxes. There's a solid box, and then in the middle, there's a dotted box, and on the west, there's another dotted box. Under the initial proposal, the solid box is what exists right now, and we were going to extend the parking lot to include the middle box.
Right.
If we extend the cul-de-sac another 73 feet, the parking lot would then be the middle box and the left-hand box. So essentially, we're not expanding the parking lot, we're just moving it 73 feet.
So the center box would not be used, you're saying?
It would be used under either scenario.
So we're talking about if we do extend the street, we're going to be using all three boxes for parking?
No, the center box and the left box.
The center?
And the left.
And the left. What would happen with the parking that is there now, then?
It'd be removed and converted to a natural state. We'd take it out and just probably put sod in.
Okay, I had to clear that up, but I agree with Alderman Police that we should not be changing the plans for one person, especially when it really doesn't have any effect on his property. Thank you.
Anything further? Alderman Wesley?
Mr. Mayor, just keep in mind when this project came to us at first, it was budget for the whole entire street. That was what the budget was for. So we are not going over the budget that was proposed for it first. So if you want to go back to square one, then we'll go all the way down with the street. That was a budget item that was approved by this council to go all the way down at one time. So sitting here and arguing about a little parking spot and not removing that blacktop, you know what? We have done over backwards for a resident at that far end of block that house been vacant, and we have been going around circles with this whole project because of that. So my suggestion is you go with the motion and vote the way you want and let it fly. I'm just saying is that it was a budget item from the capital project to go all the way down with that street. Then you guys went back and you shortened the street because a resident at the end of block house was being condemned or whatever may be done. And then this came about. Now you shorten this. Now all I'm asking is that if that guy decides to sell that empty lot, he's entitled to sell that empty lot and have it built on. And if that guy builds on that empty lot that he's entitled to, he's going to have a parking lot right across from the lot that he's entitled to sell. That's all I'm saying.
Alderman, please.
I understand that this was a budget item, but again, that's just a budget. And the one house on the end was condemned or the Forest Preserve was buying. So as a council, we had decided to shorten it to save, I think it was like $50,000 or $60,000, which is in the best interest of the city. Anything that's a budget item, if we could save money, we're going to do it. Or are we just going to spend, if everything's $100,000, we better spend the whole $100,000? We're looking to save money, bottom line.
Alderman Wesley.
I don't think it's fair for that last resident to put up with all the parking over there. This last Saturday, a Forest Preserve police officer went in the reservoir just to do a routine check between 10 and 11. He counted 25 people on that reservoir walking around. I asked him about the parking lot that was on School Street. He says it was filled. That's not fair to the resident that's there, so that parking lot needs to be moved down. And it's not fair for people that go there. So it just needs to be extended because there's more people that's using this reservoir, and it's not fair for the residents that they're going to have to park on the street.
Alderman Winger.
I personally rarely visit this area. However, it is a community space, and we have the chance to do the street and either keep it in its current size or extend it to some degree. And this, if you're going to extend it, this is the time to do it. rather than to come back and say, let's correct this again and take it down a little further. This is an area where the community will enjoy this space, and I'm for extending the street for the extra $15,000 or so. To come back and then do it again later, it's just going to cost more. And let's do it right and allow the community to enjoy the asset. Thank you.
Alderman Coles.
All right, we've talked about the street. Everybody's been down the street to look, see where it's going. We've been talking about using that water shed that's there, the pond or whatever you want to call it, for the park district wanted to use it. We wanted the parking spaces down there for we could use it. They wanted to make a place where little paddle boats could go out. The reservoir is there. This is the time when we're rebuilding the street, we might as well put the street in and put it in right and add on. And if we keep talking about $15,000, we spent more than $15,000 on things that just for studies, and we never got nothing done. And so let's stop beating around the bush. We're either going to vote on it or we ain't going to vote on it. So that's my opinion.
Alderman, please.
Well, if we're going to do it right, then since we're extending the street, let's just keep that extra parking. So now we are doing it right. We're putting in more parking spots. If we're going to do it right, let's do it right. Give the extra spots.
Alderman Cadella.
I just wanted to say that as the alderman of Ward 2, where there's a lot of forest preserve land, while I have heard of no plans to do anything with any of it, should something ever come up in the future, I'm going to fight as hard as possible to keep any public parking as far away from any resident's home as I can. So that's why I support moving this cul-de-sac further to the west, because I would hope that this council would back me and Ward 2 should we find ourselves in a similar situation.
Anything further? Roll call.
Alderman Lewitton.
I was going to speak, but Alderman Roy Wesley had his hand up, and I thought maybe he was entitled to speak first. Are we going to the roll call, or you're going to recognize Mr. Wesley?
I was going to roll call. Is there anyone else who wishes to speak to the issue?
I want the motion.
Alderman Wesley.
Oh, sorry. I want the motion to revamp. Go ahead and what was the motion?
Mr. Bond, do you recall?
Motion would be to approve the School Street project in accordance with the diagram there for a price not to exceed $16,000. And that would be with the alternative design that's depicted on the attachment to the memo, which moves the parking to the west.
The motion was for the blacktop to be removed?
Yeah. As well as removing the blacktop in the existing area.
Okay, thank you.
Anything further? Roll call.
Alderman Lewitton?
Yes.
Alderman Police?
No.
Alderman Wesley?
Yes.
Wesley? Okay. Alderman Cadella?
Yes.
Alderman Winger?
Yes.
Alderman Coles?
Yeah.
Alderman R. Wesley?
Yes.
Alderman Shockey?
No.
That passes.
Send in my report, Mayor.
Finance and Administration, Alderman Winger?
No report.
That brings us back under other business to item 9, a resolution requesting the County of DuPage to reduce the threshold intake in the Wooddale, Itasca, and the Elmhurst flood control reservoirs. Is there a motion to approve?
So moved.
Is there a second? On the question? Alderman Wesley.
Mr. Mayor, I believe I remember this very briefly here. Is this because the citizens came and asked to lower it? And wasn't it that also we were supposed to contact the other mayors and find out where we were going with that? Did we contact the other mayor?
Mr. Bond.
Yeah, we've been in touch with legal counsel for the other units of government along Salt Creek. They, what you've got before you is identical to that which they will be taking action on, and I believe Elmhurst may have already approved theirs. But yeah, we've been in touch with them as well as the county, the Public Works Department staff at the county rather than have a specific threshold, they needed a request, and the thought was, based on the initiative of this council, if we could collectively get the other units of government, the other municipalities on board with it, it would likely have more impact at the county level, and it looks like they're going to hear our request.
Okay, thank you.
And I did have the opportunity to talk to Mayor Hartwick. I have not talked to Mayor Prine as of yet. Anything further? Roll call.
Alderman Lewitton?
Yes.
Alderman Police?
Yes.
Alderman E. Wesley?
Yes.
Alderman Caddella?
Yes.
Alderman Winger?
Yes.
Alderman Coles?
Yes.
Alderman R. Wesley?
Yes.
Alderman Shockey?
Yes.
Excuse me, that's approved. We do need an executive session tonight. May I have a motion to adjourn the city council meeting into an executive session for purposes of review of the official minutes, land acquisition, and personnel pursuant to 5 ILCS 120/2C21, 2C5, and 2C1. Is there such a motion?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Second.
Roll call.
Alderman Lewitton?
Yes.
Alderman Police?
Yes.
Alderman E. Wesley?
Yes.
Alderman Caddella?
Yes.
Alderman Winger?
Yes.
Alderman Coles?
Yes.
Alderman R. Wesley?
Yes.
Alderman Shockey?
Yes.
That passes. We're adjourned.
Yeah.